Father, we come this morning. We come to thank you, Lord, for your stand before you and say thank you.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we thank you, Lord, for that you died in your presence last night. He kept us as we slept that night.
Yes.
He kept us in all dangers, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, you made the hospital be fired. Thank you.
Yes.
Lord, let your people and all come from that.
Yes. Yes.
Lord, you ain't made no destiny until we
die.
Yes, Lord. You woke up this morning, I was keeping it good, but you did it, and I'm so glad you did it, Lord. Lord, we thank you.
Yes.
Lord, we pray your holy name.
Yes.
Lord, we glorify your holy name.
Yes.
Lord, come to the hills this morning, which comes our help.
Yes.
Lord, our help comes in you, Lord, this morning.
Yes.
We come, Lord, for everything. Lord. You know our lives, we thank you.
Yes.
Lord, you have a joy, you have an attendment.
Yes.
Lord, you have a bread and a water.
Yes.
Lord, everything is Lord. You send your word, what we need, ask for the need, we shall be given.
Yes.
Lord, we believe with you what your word says. Have you stand your life, Lord. Touch our heart this morning. Touch our mind, Lord. Forgive us for our sin, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, we have sinned from you, sinned against you, Lord. And you forgive us, Lord. You're the only one who can forgive sin, Lord. Lord, let your will be done today, Lord. Bless everyone that come on the hill today, Lord. We thank you for our sisters and brothers that visit us today, Lord. Bless them today, Lord.
Yes.
Now, Lord, thank you. Let's listen for our pastor today, Lord.
Yes.
Because our pastor contains the blessing, Lord.
Yes.
Therefore, you're looking for my pastor, his wife, and his family, Lord.
Yes.
Listen, Lord.
Yes.
Because our church, Lord.
Yes.
Our church is growing great,
yes.
Lord. Let the truth will be done, Lord.
Yes.
Now, Lord, number the sinner man today. The sinner man, the woman, boy, and girl, Lord. Touch them today, Lord.
Yes.
Touch their heart. Remember those in prison tonight.
Yes.
Those in jail, Lord. Touch them, Lord.
Yes.
Those in the hospital to come to the home.
Yes.
Have mercy on them this morning, Lord.
Yes.
Now, Lord, know my people, Lord. My family, Lord, my children, my grandchildren, Lord, my sisters and brothers, thank them, Lord, those that I say, Lord. I thank the sin of the Lord. I'm going to see my whole entire family. I didn't even know where I say, Lord. Not on my family, all families, Lord. Father, ask you in Jesus' name. Now, Lord, bless us today. Let your work be done today, Lord. Let your will be done today in this service today, Lord. Let's see them know he has no demand of the place coming to deal, Lord.
Yes.
We find him right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Let's see them know he can't stay in here.
Yes.
The blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Amen, amen.
Amen.
I come to glorify his name.
Together in the Lord. So before we begin, we usher presence. 15. Psalms 42, 4 through 8. Dear pastor leaders, Jesus Ministry Bread of Life is reaching out to all the prayer warriors to join us, uniting in holy convocation. The prayer revival will be on September the 9th at 5 p.m. The revival will be held at House of Prayer for All Nations, Church of God in Christ, 1402 South 11th, Phoenix, Arizona. We will be requesting prayer leaders from different churches. We pray that your ministry will be able to participate. God is calling for true worshipers. When the saints begin to pray, the Lord will have his way in our lives, our family, our community, our churches, and in our nation. Come expect a miracle, healing, deliverance, and mighty word of God. Bring your petitions and special prayer requests. Contact Pastor Fred or Apostle Linda. And I have phone numbers here. They'll be on the board. God bless you. Amen. Here at Church of Living Water, we have Sunday school at 9:30, followed by a worship service. Amen. At 11. This Wednesday, there will be choir practice at 6:30. All those who want to sing in the choir, please be here. Amen. This Thursday, we will also be having Bible study, and it will be at 6:30. Amen. Also, if you have any cell phones, pagers, or whatever, we ask you to turn them off at this time. Amen. Unless you have an emergency, we know that some have an emergency that might have an emergency call. Put it on vibrate. Amen. But we know that God is able. Amen. Because we want you to have your minds tuned in to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And you can't do that if you're texting, amen, your friends. Amen. It doesn't work. Amen. So govern yourself according to the announcement. I heard one announcement. I heard something today, Pastor Blair, that Powerhouse was having their church anniversary.
Yes.
Is that true? Have you heard anything today? We haven't got anything on that. They said today at 4 o'clock. I did not hear anything of that. Didn't see anything of that nature. So we'll find out after church and see. Okay, so just govern yourself according to the announcements. Amen?
Amen.
How many feel good in your sanctified soul? I'm going to take the time to welcome my family from the other side. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let's give them a hand. Jesus is going to bring them life. Amen? Fresh anointing in the house.
Yeah.
Somebody come to lift up the name of Jesus. Somebody come to give him glory and praise. Amen. Hallelujah.
You don't know how much I appreciate that. But I know God does. And I thank him for it. And also I want to thank the church for praying for me and my family at this period. I got a lot of information yesterday about my niece. I was thinking that, I was wondering whether she belonged to church or not. I never asked her and I never talked to her about it. We always communicate over the phone. I found out yesterday she do belong to the Catholic Church, and they will have her service next Saturday. And I do have somebody to represent me there, my daughter and a couple of my granddaughters. They are going to the service, thank God. My son looked at me when I told him that my niece had passed. You should have went and seen her. Do you want to go now? No, I don't want to go now. I didn't go when she was living. Why should I go when she died? No, thank you. I do thank God because he has been blessing our family and he also blessed me. And I thank God for that because if it wasn't for him, we couldn't make it. You know, I thank the church for their blessings also. And I just want to say that I thank God for our visitors this morning. They did surprise me because I hadn't seen them in a long time. And I thank God for them. I thank God for blessing them to travel to come over to see us for church anyway. And I hope that he blessed them to travel back home safe and sound. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Thank
you. Praise the Lord.
First, I give honor to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to the shepherd to this hour. The Lord has been so good, you know. I changed jobs. The Lord got me on a different journey. I drive a semi now. And I was all the way in Indianapolis, Indiana at a Snyder OC yard. And I had a brand new 2017 Freightliner, and it just stopped. I lost all electrical, everything going to Chicago. But God had a different plan, a different purpose, because he directed me back to the OC in Indianapolis, Indiana, and there was a guy, a kid that I ran into that he put in my path, and he looked like his spirit was, he was troubled. So the Lord, I began to open up to him and speak word into him, speak life into him, and he says, you know, I asked him, you know, do you believe in Jesus? He said, yes, I do believe in Jesus. My parents are pastors. And so I said, believe this, that your parents are praying for you. Now, because they're PK kids, doesn't mean that he didn't go astray. He went astray. And he said, my parents tell me this. The same thing that you're telling me, my parents tell me. So I ran back into him, and he says, everything is good. Everything's right. And I thank the Lord, because the Lord will put people in your path to speak a word to you, to if we get off course or we get astray. Yeah, he sent the Holy Ghost, but sometimes he'll send people in our path to speak something into us. So that was the first one. The second one is when the company put me up in the Red Roof Inn. The lady that was behind the counter, young girl, 23 years old, going to school, the nursing program. She works at the Red Roof Inn in Indianapolis, Indiana, for 2 days a week. I asked her if she believed in Christ. She says, yes, no. I said, what's the, you know, why not? They opened up the door for it. She said, well, you know, we went to a church when I was younger, and my mom used to sell me for crack on the street. I lived underneath the bridge, so the Lord opened up the door. I ended up beginning to minister to her, and I gave her parts in the Bible. I said, get hooked up into a church. She said, well, there is a lady that I go to church with. It's a Presbyterian church. I said, we get into a Bible that's from Genesis to Revelation that preaches about the cross. I said, you read John, Gospel of John, and you read the first chapter of Genesis. I said, you read those, you pray. You need to know how to pray. Go into Matthew and read the Lord's Prayer. I said, by doing this, you ask the Lord, the Holy Spirit, to open up and give you revelation of the Word. So I trust and believe, because the Word says in Corinthians 3:6, one plants, one waters, but Christ gives the increase. I don't know, I was the planter, Christ is going to send somebody else the water, but he's going to get the glory. And so, I know all things are possible through Christ. There was no reason why that on my journey, I know I was sent in that direction for those people, so he could get the glory. That's my testimony.
Amen. Someone else have a praise. So we know God's been good to all of us.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes, Mr. Passed, amen. And God let me down there. You know,
the same thing that I was going through and things that I was on with an auto accident. Amen. My car got towed. Amen. And got out there and my daughter's car got towed out. But you know, in all of that, amen, that was coming up on me, God had a better plan.
Yes.
Things didn't get worse, they got better.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. He gave us something better than what we already had.
Yes.
And I know it was the grace of God, so I just give him life, amen. I appreciate him, and I really know him, amen. I appreciate where I am in Christ. Amen. Want to go higher, okay?
Yes.
Amen. I thank God, amen, that I have leaders, amen, that's able to see me through. I love them, amen.
Amen.
Them on the box. And I said so many things, amen. She's speaking, I just suck it up. Amen. I just trying to get all I can get, amen. My soul gets blessed, amen, when I hear the gospel, amen, of Jesus Christ. Thank God for going on the cross, shedding his blood.
Yes.
Rising again. Yes. That I can have life after the cross.
Yes.
Amen, is that when we leave this place, there's a place in Christ in it. All these things that we're going through, amen. God already said so. No more crying. No more suffering. Amen. Don't worry about the daily, amen. Don't worry about the night.
God is good.
Yeah. 10,000? And I told her, I said, yes. I told her, I said, I believe it's around 20 or 22,000. She said, well, maybe go over. And she went through all the information that I had. She pulled out all my student loan, and she found out that I owe over $34,000 plus interest.
Yes, yes.
After she got all that, she turned around, she went back in. She said that you were qualified for the government forgiveness student plan. Mom, they brought it all the way from $35,000 to $5,000. She told me, as long as you pay $248 for the next 3 months, every 15th of the month after that, you pay $20.
Oh, praise God.
So, thank God.
Yeah.
Because, you know, he said to wait on him.
Yes.
And when you start waiting on God, he gives you the encouragement and the strength in your heart to continue to press on.
Yeah.
And I thank God because he is the love of my soul.
Yes.
If it wasn't for him, I would not be able to do what I'm doing for God. Because we're on this earth for his purpose, and to do his will, and to do his kingdom work. A lot of people ask me, well, you know, why you do this every Sunday? I said, because it brings joy to my heart that I can be able to do what God told me to do. Serving the food, cooking the food, doing whatever God said to do, you just do it. You don't ask questions. I ask God to continue to keep me humble, keep me faithful, and be obedient to what God said to do.
Amen.
So that is my testimony.
Amen.
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 Come on, give the Lord a hand praise. Amen.
Took my heart and just I just want to thank you.
because of who you are, it's my testimony today. I give you all the glory and I give you all the praise. Amen. I thank first of all to God who always been in my life, to my pastor, to Pastor Hines, amen, to Pastor Wilson, to Apostle Wilson, to the deacons, to the mothers, to whom I was due, the evangelists, amen. Truly, I just thank God for just being here one more time, amen. I thank God for his mercy, amen. I thank God because, you know, every time you think that you going through, like you say, going through out of the wilderness, here comes that old ugly stinker pop his head back up again, amen. And I said, you know what, Lord? I says, you know, I'm getting very, very tired of this devil, amen. And so the child they put my foot on his neck, amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. But I just thank God because it could be worse. You know, it could be worse. But somebody's going through something worse than I am.
Yes.
You know, but I thank God for my life, my health, and my strength. And also, I thank God for the Holy Ghost. I thank God for his keeping power. That he keeps me checked sometimes. Sometimes I do be crazy because I only have the flesh. Amen. But I thank God I can go back and repent. Amen.
Yes.
I thank God that he can cut me off before I repent. Amen. But I thank God we're human just like everybody else is human. Amen. We got feelings just like everybody else got feelings. Amen. But I thank God for his mercy. Amen. I thank God for his grace. Amen. I don't have a little baby with me today, but she turned 1 year old this past week. Amen. So now I have a 1-year-old, 3-year-old, a 5-year-old. Amen. But I thank God for giving me and my husband the strength to go on and see what the end's going to be. Amen. Every day is not howdy, howdy, but I thank God for the strength that he has given us at our age. Amen. To be able to love and to care for these children. Amen. So y'all continue to pray for us as we pray for you. And remember my mom in prayer. Remember my sister Yvette in prayer. She had appendicitis late last night and put her into surgery, but she's doing well. Amen. They operated. She had went to one hospital, and they told her, oh, it's just, you know, something wrong with her intestinal gas or something, and they sent her home. But she was persistent, so she went further down the road from Hanford to Clovis, headed to Fresno. And she went to the Clovis Hospital. That's when they ran the test and found out that she was having appendicitis. They just put her right into surgery. She had to go home, and did what the hospital people said. She probably would have died last night. But I thank God for his life, health, and his strength. I thank God for praying people, amen, that we pray for each other's family, amen. No matter what we're going through, amen, no matter what we don't see, each other, we're still praying for one another. And I just thank God for each and every one of you. So did pray for me as I pray for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
At this time, we're going to lift up our offering, amen.
Offering time.
Offering time.
Amen.
Amen.
He's a son of man.
Loving worship.
Search a child that lives in water, fire. We sing our praises unto our God. He gives us blessings and he answers our prayer. So we keep moving on for our God. Church of the living waters, fire. We sing our praises unto our God. He gives us blessings and he answers.
But amen, we're going to call on Pastor and yesterday where we're going to be, where we headed to. I'm just waiting for more. I can't even get fed, Mother. I just can't even get some word. And I'm passing Fred time to get him something so I can get fed. I already got my plate empty. I say, Lord, I'm here for you. And that's it. I'm going to reserve a word because I feel I'm here to get fed and ministered to. And that's all right.
Amen.
That's all right. Sometimes though we give. I'm in a receiving mode today. That's all right. You gotta pray for me because I'm going through. And a lot of times when you go through, sometimes you have to get step back and just get a word. You know, because I tell you, admit I'm not perfect. I strive for perfection. But when I need a word, I need a word.
Yes.
So today I'm waiting on the Lord to give me something I can feast on. Amen.
Hallelujah.
God is a good God.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
I just want to say thank God for carrying us over the highway.
Amen.
Don't give me this long. I'm not here. We drove so that we could come and eat. Amen. Amen. We drove so that we could come and eat. I want to say thanks to all those who decided to come with us today.
Amen.
You know, I just give Mother Marsh my little, if I could give her a nudge, you know, she preaching a little bit. Don't take much. But I have a question I want to ask you. And this is pretty simple. Everybody knows the address, is that right?
Amen.
I just want to ask you what your address is. If you're looking for God to deliver today, want to know what your address is, because you know, he can't deliver to the street corner. He needs somewhere to deliver your blessing.
Amen.
Well, I want to ask you now, what's your address? Mother, is it Fear Street? You know, God, he don't deliver Pastor Hine on Fear Street. That's not where God operates. Amen. Because if you're afraid, the enemy's got you down. If you're afraid, I'm telling you, if you're afraid, he's got you down. So we already know that God don't operate on Fear Street. He don't deliver nothing on Fear Street. Well, maybe some of y'all might be living on that street.
Come on, all right now.
You ready?
Right.
Somebody might be living on Doubt Street.
All right. Now.
Well, I'm here to inform you today that God don't deliver to Doubt Street.
All right. Now.
You see, because the Bible says if you doubt, even when you pray, he said you might as well quit. Don't be praying if you're doubting God.
Yes.
Now, I'll tell you what God does deliver. He delivers on Faith Street.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. That's what he delivers. He delivers on Faith Street.
Faith Street.
Now, how many of y'all, I was listening to some music this morning. Carl Pearson said, you know, how many of y'all had a little bout this morning with the enemy before you got here? Amen. But because you know that you know that you know.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right.
Because I know.
Yes.
We came here today that we might be fed of God. We came in faith. Now, the Bible says that we were reading something in Psalm today, was it? Was it Psalm 34 we were reading this morning?
Yes, sir.
It said that God delivers us out of all of our troubles. But he don't do that unless we are faithful.
Right.
Unless we believe whatever it is God said. He said, I'll be with you. He told somebody, Lord, I'll be with you to the end of the age. That's what he said to them. And so if we begin to doubt that he's going to be with us, we might as well go home. We made a 200-mile drive for nothing.
Yes.
If we don't believe that God is going to deliver. So Pastor Brad, I just come. I come on Faith Street today. I come on Faith Street today so that you can go ahead and feed us. So come on, y'all just say amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
hearts and minds of your people. Father, there's healing in the building right now. There's deliverance in the building right now. There's salvation in the building right now. If we only trust in you, Father, I thank you and I praise you. I magnify you and lift you up. Lord, give us a mind that we want to be saved.
Thank you, Lord.
Let you come on in. Oh, yes, Lord Jesus. You have a gift for us.
Yes.
So we're going to give you our address. Father, bless us right now.
Yes.
Bless right now.
Amen.
Bless your word as you go forth. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Just for our few moments, I think I want to go to, amen, the book of St. Luke, chapter 8. Amen. I want to look at verse 43 through 46. St. Luke chapter 8. Amen.
Amen.
St. Luke chapter 8. St. Luke chapter 8, verse 43 through 46. Then I want to go to St. Luke 15, 17, and 18. Try to tie these two in together. Amen?
Amen.
Luke 8, 43 and 46. And a woman having an issue of blood 12 years, which had spent all her living upon physician, neither could be healed of any, came behind him and touched order of his garment, and immediately her issue of blood stands. And Jesus said, who touched me? And all that denied Peter and they that were with him said, Master, the multitude throw thee and pressed thee, and said, thou who touched me? Verse 46. And Jesus said, somebody has touched me.
Yes.
For I perceive that virtue is gone out of me.
Go.
And I want to go to St. Luke 15, real quick. 17 and 18, St. Luke. Amen?
Amen.
15, chapter 15, 17 and 18. Amen. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father have bread enough and to spare? And I perish with hunger. I will arise and go to my father and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. Amen.
Amen.
Let me see. Hallelujah. Today we want to use as a text, a subject. Today, wake up.
Wake up. All right.
Look at self.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Wake up and look at self.
Yes.
Amen. Anytime we want to look, but we want to look at somebody else. Do you know we can find more fault in somebody else than we can in our own self?
Amen.
True.
Because we're always looking out.
Yes.
We need to look in.
Yes, yes.
Amen. You can't do nothing about nobody else's condition. Their faults. But you can look at your own.
Mm-hmm.
Do something about it. Amen. Wake up and look at self. And after you do it all day, then you can come home.
Amen.
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 Then you can come home. Yeah. See, if you can't see yourself and get yourself straight, you're still lost.
Amen.
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 I don't hear that little imagine up on the hill.
All right.
Amen. That's not your home. Your home is in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. When you come to Jesus Christ, you can come home.
Yes.
Amen. Somebody never going to kick you out.
Mm-hmm.
You can kick yourself out, but he's going to kick you out.
Well, right. Come on.
Amen. Hallelujah. We see here that many times we look, amen, at our conditions, and most of us have a lot of issues. Amen. A lot of issues.
Well, amen.
Amen. But we don't know how to deal with these issues.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We like to go around and try to give somebody else our problems. Amen. Give somebody else our conditions and things of that nature. But we need to look at self.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
This woman has issue of blood 12 years.
Come on.
Spent every dime that she had to the doctors.
Yes.
Physician meeting.
Yes.
Amen. All these kind of doctors coming in. I guess she had some witchcrafts and all this coming in, trying to heal her, but nothing could heal her. Amen. Hallelujah. Until she made up her mind, she need to go to Jesus.
Yes. Yes. My Lord. Mm-hmm. Come on.
Amen. All right now. Some of us is running around in circles. You know how a dog, you ever see a dog chase his tail?
Come on.
Amen. Some of us chasing our tail, running around in circles.
Well.
And all we got to do is stop.
Yeah.
And look at what we're doing.
All right. Now.
Amen. And look at self. And want self to be better than you were yesterday.
Uh-huh.
I can understand some people in this world. Amen. And I tell them all, I don't care how young you are, how old you are.
Right.
I said, when you're older, you're going to act crazy anyway.
Amen.
Come on.
But when you get a little age on, you should be looking at self to come in.
Come on. Amen.
Put that self behind you.
Yeah.
Amen. You know, I told my daughter when she had her first baby, I think at 17, and I told her, I said, now you're grown. She's not getting grown at 18. No, no, you got a family now. Uh-huh. You're grown. So you got to take care of self. And I'm so glad she took care of herself. Because, hallelujah, I wasn't going to step out and do a lot for her. I wanted her to see what life was really all about. Sometimes we depend upon other people. We depend upon our doctors.
Amen.
We depend upon our lawyers. We'd rather go to counsel than talk to a pastor. We'd rather, amen, go to cross the border to witchcraft.
Mm.
Amen. And then to read the word of God. Amen. But I'm here to tell you, all they want is money.
Yes.
Amen. So if you want your money, go to Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is the answer to all your problems if you allow him to fix it.
Amen.
Now you have to allow him to do it, though.
Yes, that's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Heal this woman, hallelujah. And this woman had an issue of blood for 12 years, but had spent all her living.
Yes.
Hallelujah. All her living. Nothing could heal her.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Hello.
That's what I'm trying to tell you today is what you see in this world today. Amen. You think you're going to get an alcohol bottle that's going to heal you. It won't heal you.
No, no.
Mm-hmm.
When you get sober, you're going to be worse than you was before you start drinking.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. You're looking for some kind of drugs to heal you. Hallelujah. You won't be healed. You can find yourself stealing from your grandma and mama, hallelujah, trying to get more drugs, and still won't be healed.
Amen.
You go to the doctor, pour out all your money to the doctors. The doctor say you won't be healed, you can't be healed. You have to keep coming back every month. Come back, come back. Hallelujah. You go to Jesus.
Yes.
Turn to Jesus. Let Jesus work in your life.
Yes.
Turn to Jesus, hallelujah. And this woman, hallelujah, came to Jesus. And I love, hallelujah, in St. Luke 15, the prodigal son, hallelujah, he had to see himself.
Yes.
You know, he took out, hallelujah, his heritage while he was young. Amen. That's why I say young people ain't crazy anyway.
Uh-huh.
Amen. We're not going to spend it all telling everybody how big he can be with a couple of dollars. But those dollars are going to run out pretty soon.
Amen.
Amen. Because I'm a living witness of it. Hallelujah. When them dollars run out, hallelujah, what you going to do then?
All right.
Go back to the one you have not the most.
Yes,
they don't even know you.
That's right.
Yeah. Go to the one, hallelujah. Hey, you bought clothes for him. Bought that brand new suit and shoes for him. Hallelujah. Tell him that I need a piece of bread. He can say, I don't know you. Amen. Let me tell you something. You got to look at yourself and get yourself right with God.
Amen.
Wake up. It's time for us to get our lives back together.
That's right.
It's time for us to see Jesus Christ.
Yes.
It's time for us not to keep walking away from him. Hallelujah. He's standing waiting with his arms wide open.
Yes.
Say, come to me, hallelujah.
Yes.
He said, it's late and heavy late. And we still running, going and doing what we want to do.
Uh-huh.
It's time for us to. Amen. Humble ourselves.
Humble, yes.
Humble ourselves.
Yes, Lord.
This woman, hallelujah, after lost everything she had. Been
ain't no nothing else to do. Looking for the dollar to come back again, he didn't show up. Because he done took all the money. Hallelujah. But she heard about a man who's coming through this city.
All right,
and she heard about a man, hallelujah, that can heal. She heard about a man, hallelujah, if I just only get to touch his hem of his garment.
Yes.
She didn't want to go hug him. She didn't want, hallelujah, be seen by anybody else because she had an issue of blood. She didn't supposed to be around other people. But she crawled through the crowd, hallelujah, and made her way all the way up to the front, hey, keep on moving forward, hallelujah. Sooner or later, you're going to get there, hallelujah. And all you got to do, hallelujah, just touches him in the right.
Touch.
Hey, hallelujah. I heard, hallelujah, somebody was saying, he touched me.
Yeah.
Hey, hallelujah. When you touch him, he touches you.
Yeah.
Hey, hallelujah. Sometimes y'all ready to touch you, you don't even know about it. Yeah. Hey, hallelujah. He's waiting on you to touch him, hallelujah. Yeah. Hey, when you go through this crowd, hallelujah, of life, hey, hallelujah, you got everything against us. Everything, knock us down when we stand up, hallelujah. Hey, you get a dollar or two, somebody take it from you, hallelujah. But I'm here today to tell you, go to Jesus, hallelujah. Hey, and touch the hill of the God. Hey, crawl through the crowd, hallelujah. If you can lay down and walk through the crowd, get to the hill of the God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. Because there's healing in the touch of his garment.
Yes.
Hey, there's delivering in the touch of his garment. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hey, there's salvation in the touch of his garment.
Yes.
Hey, there's touch, hallelujah. You will be made whole. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. When you can see yourself, hallelujah, and you're dirty and nasty. Hey, hallelujah. You want to be clean. You need to walk in toward Jesus, hallelujah.
Yes.
And walk the hallelujah, Jesus. And somebody get in your way, hallelujah. Just crawl through the legs, hallelujah. And I'm saying I got to get to Jesus, hallelujah. Because he has what I need. He has salvation. He has hallelujah, Jesus. What I need to say, hallelujah.
My God.
My Bible tells me all sickness, not unto death.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Sometimes, hallelujah, we allow these things to get up on us so we can't go to Jesus. So a lot of times we want to go everywhere else but to Jesus.
That's right.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Let me tell you something. I remember my time, hallelujah. I used to have, I had a toothache. Hey, hallelujah. I said, I'm not going to the dentist. Hey, hallelujah. I'm not going to go to this dentist. I went to work. Hallelujah. Working in the back. Hey, that thing hit me so hard, I ran out the back door.
I know you.
Didn't stop when I got to the dentist's office. My brother said, you can't do that, you're going to get fired. I said, I don't care. Hallelujah. I'm going to make it to that dentist.
Yes.
Came back in, hallelujah. My brother standing there, let me in the back door. Hey, hallelujah, so I can sneak in. Hallelujah, Jesus. But I'm telling you, hallelujah, when that pain of life hit me so hard, hey, hallelujah, you can run to safety. You need to find out for you, hallelujah. If I had a tooth, I know I need to go to the dentist, hallelujah. Jesus, oh my Lord, hallelujah. When I need the needs replacement, I know I need to go to the doctor, hallelujah. But hey, when I need my soul saved, I need to go to Jesus, hallelujah. I need to go to Jesus, hallelujah. What I love about both these stories, about this lady and this young man, hallelujah. It says, the woman said in verse 9:21, for she said within herself, if I may touch his garment, I shall be whole. So you got to have faith. You got to have faith, hallelujah, that you're going to do it. You got to have faith, hallelujah, that you will make it. You got to have faith, hallelujah, that nothing can stop me, hallelujah. I'm going to get through and touch the hand of the God. And I'm so glad, hallelujah. Hey, one day I had to make it through, hallelujah. I had to get there. I've been running for a long time, hallelujah. Lord, thought I was saved and all of this stuff. You know, we have too many people to come to the altar. Hey, hallelujah.
All right.
You have a famous person come in, hallelujah. They line up.
Yes.
Coming for a blessing. They come up, hallelujah. All they do is touch you and pray for you, hallelujah. Yeah, some of you even saying you got a $50 blessing, the Lord's gonna bless you, hallelujah.
Right.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah, you have a low line. And next week they over in Phoenix. They people hear about the same people go do the same thing, get in line again.
Huh?
Amen. Give the money again. Hey, looking for a blessing. But I'm here today to tell you, hallelujah. You don't need to go to any place.
Right.
You need to get a blessing right where you are right now.
All right.
I'm here today to tell you, hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
Glory
to God.
I was sitting at home, sitting on the side of the bed. Hallelujah. Wasn't even thinking about a blessing from the Lord. Hallelujah. All I know, I started saying, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And the Lord touched me. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hey, hallelujah, Lord. Jesus. And he said, go now. I'm sending you out to preach.
Yes.
Not me, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, not me. Hallelujah. I'm like, oh, I can't even speak clearly. He said, you go and I'll be with you. Hallelujah. And I'm so glad. Hallelujah. He touched me that day. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yeah, hallelujah. I'm going to run. Hallelujah. what we need. We run to Jesus, because that Savior, hallelujah. He that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide. Hallelujah, Jesus. If we run to Jesus, hey, he will save us. He will keep us. Amen? Amen. I'm so glad. Amen. One thing about when you turn to Jesus Christ, amen, when you touch him, he knows it. Sometimes you wonder why, hallelujah, things are not going the way. See, a lot of times we say, well, I went to church on Sunday, I heard a good word, amen. Even tear fell down. Mm-hmm. But you still haven't looked at yourself. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. You can shed many tears. Still don't know who you are. In Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When you look at yourself, you can see
I know.
How ugly you are.
Amen.
Amen. I don't care how you walk around here, thank you most. Amen. The prettiest thing on this earth.
All right, now.
Amen. Some of us dress like we think it's the prettiest thing on this earth. But let me tell you something. When you look at yourself and see how you look, you go home and dress different.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. When you can see yourself, I'm trying to, in your spiritual eye, when you can see yourself, you'll be a better person.
Yes.
You treat everybody else different.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You wouldn't mind going over to somebody that you dislike
mm-hmm.
and tell them how good God is. Yes.
Amen.
But you can see yourself.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Many of us can't see ourselves. We're going to close. There are some people been in church for many, many years. They've been in church, but church is not in them.
That's right. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Some of them been holding great position in church.
Right.
Amen.
Yeah.
But I'm here today to tell you, it's not about me or you. It's about Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen. It's about the one that shed his blood.
Amen. Amen.
It's about the one, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Gave up life. That we can be saved.
Yes, yes, yes.
You know, neither one of us were worthy of him doing what he did, but he loved us so much. Amen. Now, the song we sang, I say that, amen, that's a debt. Amen. We owe. We could not pay. But he paid the debt for us.
Yes, he did.
Amen. He died for our sin.
Yes.
He died for our sin.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen.
My God.
Hallelujah. He died for our sin. And he rose on the third day with all power in his hand. Let me tell you something. Because of him dying on the cross, because that he rose again, they still didn't understand. Even the disciples that were walking with him, that were called apostles, they fully didn't understand what was going on. But they followed the direction.
Amen.
They told him, go wait.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Wait till you be endued with power.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. See, because he said, hallelujah. Until you receive that power, you don't have anything.
That's right.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
First, Acts 1 and 8 says, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost comes.
Yes, yes.
Any of us walking around thinking we have power. Amen. You can tell somebody else how to be saved, how to be filled with the Holy Ghost. And you don't know nothing about the Holy Ghost. Because if it had not come into your life, how can you know anything about it? And I'm here today to tell you, hallelujah, Jesus Christ, the only one. true church.
Yes.
Not a building.
Yes.
But individuals that are ready to give their life to Christ.
Yes.
And I'm here today to tell you how it is. Wake up. Wake up. And look yourself. Stop looking at other people. You know we can find fault all the time in somebody else.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
So we can't find fault in ourselves. Amen. I tell anybody all the time, listen to my influence. If I can find fault in somebody else, there got to be something right here.
Amen.
So I got to look at me first.
Yes.
Amen. How can I tell somebody to clean up their house when their house is dirty?
Amen, amen, amen.
How can I tell somebody to get the beam out of their house when I got a log in mine?
Right. Amen.
Amen. We got to clean up our house first.
Yes.
That's why I said, wake up and look at self.
That's right. Amen.
If you look at self hard enough, you'll see self. You can see where you are. Hallelujah. You might have got running, hallelujah. Like we had service here, and we had a shady one night. A young lady was sitting over there, and she got up into the restroom. She walked in the restroom, as soon as she walked by the mirror, she came and run back and fell down at my feet. And I was standing right there. She said, Pastor, you need to pray for me right now, because I don't like what I saw. Honestly. See, I don't like what I saw, and I don't want it no more. Hallelujah. So what I'm saying is, if we look at ourselves close enough, we can see that demon in us.
Yes.
We shouldn't want him anymore.
God.
We need to release him and tell him, get out of my life.
Yes.
Hey, hallelujah. I want to be cleansed with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Tell that demon to flee from me. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hey, I want joy and happiness.
Yes.
Whenever you got the demon on the inside of you, you're not joyful. You're not happy. Hey, it's trouble on every side. But I'm here today to tell you, we need the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit
is
the only thing I'm going to say.
Amen?
Amen. And I'm so glad. See, I came from a Baptist background. I mean, an old traditional Baptist background. Amen. They didn't believe in women's even coming up to the pulpit. They let them preach it.
That's right.
Amen. 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 Hallelujah. A lot of things they didn't believe in. But I'm so glad that they're changing now.
Change.
It's a big change going on. Amen. The only thing I hope is the Holy Ghost change, they tell them to change.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. I have a friend that lived in Glide. We were talking about less than a year ago. And he called me and he says, Pastor, I heard that they have an apostolic Baptist church in St. Louis. Now, in Louisiana. Apostolic Baptist Church. I said, well, I hope they got the truth.
Mm-hmm.
I just hope they got the truth. That's all. Mm-hmm. We were talking, just talking, just talking. When I went back there, my wife called and looked for apostolic church that I wanted to go to. We found one. Apostolic Methodist Church. I didn't look for it. I didn't go because I didn't have time anyway. I think my brother back there for it. But I took my brother ride the next day and went out into the country. They had a big old beautiful church out there, the grass was green around. And when I bought the cast, I said, whoa, wait a minute. Apostolic Methodist Church. I said, now, I hope the apostolic movement is taking over. Amen. I hope that the Holy Spirit is moving in there.
Yes.
Amen. They get filled with the Holy Ghost. That's one thing I can say. Amen. Hallelujah. Because when you say the apostolic church, that means you have to be teaching what the apostles taught.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus left directions to the apostles to teach us.
Amen.
Amen. So I hope that they got the truth. I just want to let you know. Amen. Things have changed. I went to the church that I used to be a member of back then. And the Sunday school lesson was about, hallelujah, Acts chapter 5, I believe it was, the first deacons. And the preacher was, he did the review. And I heard him talk about the Holy Spirit and the Holy Ghost. My eyes got big. When I left that, you said the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, they said you're crazy. Yeah. And my eyes got big. I said, whoa, I need to go back and talk to him. But the Spirit of God is moving.
Yes.
whether people are liking or not, the Holy Spirit is moving because Jesus is soon to come.
Amen.
And he's coming soon. Amen. He's coming soon. He said, well, my great grandpa been talking about this for years and years. It doesn't matter. He's coming.
Yeah, he is.
He's coming.
Yes.
He's just waiting on us to get it right.
Amen.
Waiting on the church to get it right. That's all. That's why he delayed as it is today. Amen. I heard somebody say a long time ago, the reason why the world is still standing today is because that's a praying saints. That's a praying saints. Or he would have got mad and destroyed everything. But because of praying saints, he waiting on the church to get it right. Pray for me, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word. We thank you for the opportunity to speak to your people. Help us, Lord Jesus, to understand it's all about you, not self. Father, if we only turn from our wicked ways, hallelujah, and turn to you, you would heal our man. Hey, you were here for help to heal our man. Father, I thank you and I praise you and I magnify you right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. If anyone here desires prayer, amen, for any reason, I pray a prayer of faith. Amen. I'm not God, and I don't claim to be God. Hallelujah. But we do pray by faith. Amen. Amen. If you're here today, amen, that can come to the altar. If there's anyone that out of awkward safety, amen, he's come to Jesus right now. He may come in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. If you're here today, hallelujah, may come to Jesus.
Thank you.
We take things we see it, hallelujah, not only as the juice, hallelujah, but as what you have said, this is my body, this is my blood. But we're going to see it in our spiritual man. Bless it right now. Bless these elements, Lord, as we take them in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Hallelujah.
I know it was enough for me. One day I was lost. He died on the cross. I know it.
you. Amen. May this rest of this day be joyful. Hallelujah and hallelujah. May God give you peace. Let us stand. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.